students. See here, exercise 15. Exercise 15. Question number 13. See, before that, what instructions are given? In 13 to 16, obtain an equation using the letter given in the bracket. Means what it is given? From 13 question to 16 question, what we have to do? We have to just create equation. We have to just form equation. Okay. But now see, from 17 to 20, see, after 16 question, what it is given in the textbook? 17 to 20, solve the equation obtained in 13 to 16 above and find the value of the letter used. Means what it is given in 13 to 16 question, it is given to just form equation. Okay. And for same questions, what it is given 17 to 20, for 17 to 20 we have to use the same question from 13 to 16. We have to use the same equation from that question and just we have to solve. So what I am going to do, while showing this equation only, I will explain the value of that given letter. Okay, means we will find the real value of that variable. Okay, so now what it is given in the question? 5 times the number in my mind is 35. And what it is given? Later we have to use N. The number is in my mind is N. Okay? 5 times the number in my mind is 35. Okay? So, 5 times the number in my mind. In my mind, which number is there that I don't know? And it's 5 times. So the number which we don't know, what we use? We use the something later, we use the variable for that. So here it is given, we have to use N. Okay, so let the number in my mind be N. Here it is given. We have to take the number in my mind is N. Okay. So let the number in my mind be N. Okay. Now what it is given? 5 times the number in my mind. 5 times. Which word came? Times. Times word will come, then we have to multiply 5 times. So 5 times number in my mind. Okay, 5 times number in my mind is 35. Okay, is 35. So 5 times, times means multiplication, number in my mind, what I have taken, let the number in my mind be N. The number which we don't know, we consider something later, but now we are given letter N. So what I consider that letter N. Okay, so the 5 times, times means multiply, number in my mind, what I consider N is 35. Is 35, so is equal to 35. So this is our equation. Understood? See, 5 times number in my mind is 35. 5 times the number, times means multiplication. See, 5 I have written as it is. In the place of times, I have written multiplication sign. Number in my mind, what we consider? N. So multiplied by N, number in my mind is equal to N. See, let the number in my mind be N. So N we have to take here. Is 35. Is. So is equal to 35. The number is in my mind is 5. The number is in my mind. 5 times the number in my mind is 35. So is 35, so is equal to 35. Now let's solve this equation. Now you have learned the rule, transposal rule, you have learned or not? See when we solve the equation. Now see, 5 into n, which operation is given here? Multiplication is given. Now 5, suppose I want to transfer to right hand side. Now 5 is which side? 5 is left hand side. If I want to transfer 5 to the right hand side, now 5 is here, multiplied, if we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become divide. See, so I will transfer 5 to the right hand side, then it will become divide. So we will write here down 35 divided by 5. See here, I will explain you the rules. See here, if minus sign is this side, if you want to transfer this negative number to right hand side, then when we transfer this number to this side, then it will become plus. Okay, if plus, if any number has plus sign, if we transfer that number to the right hand side, then it will become minus. Same way, now if number is here multiplied, now which operation in between? Multiplication. If we transfer to right hand side, then it will become divide. If in here it is divide, if we will transfer this number to the right hand side, that will become multiplied. Same way, if now we are going to transfer right hand side number to the left hand side number, if it is plus, if we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become minus. Okay, see, if the number is minus for right hand side, if we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become plus. If number is divided for right hand side, if we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become multiplied. If the number is multiplied for right hand side, if we will transfer to left hand side, then it will become divide. Okay, means see, again I will repeat. If the number is here minus, if we transfer to right hand side, then it will become plus. Okay, if here it is plus, if we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become minus. If here is multiplied, if we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become divide. If here it is divide, operation is divide, and if we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become multiplied. Okay, now see here, 5 into n, which operation is here? Multiplied. If we will transfer this 5 to the right hand side, 5 is here, multiplied. 5 for this n, it is multiplied. If we will transfer to right hand side, see, I want to transfer this 5 to the right hand side, then it will become divide. So m is equal to 35 upon 5. So m is equal to, now 5. 5 ones are 5, 5 sevens are 35. So m is equal to 7. So the number, let the number in my mind be m. So that number is, the number in my mind is 7. So the number in my mind is 7. So now this for 13th one question, what it was given, just we have to create the equation. See, this is equation. Just we have to create the equation, and from 17 what it is given, the same equation, means from 13th question equation we have to solve for 17, means we have to find the answer for this A. So I have shown both the examples in one sum only. Okay, here we have to create the equation and we have to solve the equation. So again, I am not going to explain from 17 example. Okay, let's solve question number 14. If a number less than 15, if a number less than 15, a number, the number which we don't know, that is less than 15, means that is smaller than 15. Okay, b subtracted from 15, what it is given, that b subtracted from 15, the result is 9. And what we have to use? The letter n we have to use. The number which we don't know, that we have to use n. Okay, so if number less than 15, number, okay, let the number be n. If a number less than 15, a number means which number, that we don't know. So let the number which we don't know, we consider the letter. Okay, so here given which letter? N. So let the number be n. Okay, let the number be n. Okay, what it is given? If a number means this, it is less than 15. Okay, we consider that number n, that is less than 15. B subtracted from 15 means this. This number we consider n. This b subtracted from 15. B subtracted from 15 means from 15 we have to subtract n. Properly listen this. If a number less than 15, the number which we don't know, we consider n. So let the number be n. And this n is less than, if a number less than 15 and this n is less than 15, means it is smaller number than 15. Okay, b subtracted from 15. From 15 this b subtracted. The b subtracted from 15. From 15 n b subtracted. The result is this is equal to what it is given. The result is 9. Is equal to 9. What it is given? The result is 9. So is equal to 9. So how to create equation understood? Now see, same question you have to solve for the 18th. Okay. Here it is given just to create equation. And in 18th question what it is given? We have to solve this equation in 18th question. So I am going to show here only. Okay. So I am going to show here only. Okay. So again I will explain. If a number less than 15, a number, the number which we don't know, we consider n. Let the number be n. That is less than 15. That information we know. This number is less than 15. Means it is smaller than 15. This is smaller than 15. And what it is given? B subtracted from 15. Means from this 15 it should be the subtracted. N should be the subtracted. The result is 9. So what we get? The result 9. Means is equal to 9. The result is 9. Means when we subtract this number from 15 we get 9 answer. Okay. The meaning of question, when we subtract this number from 15, the result is 9. Means we get 9. So let's solve this equation. Okay. Now what I said you, rules I have explained you. If number is here, minus. If we will transfer to that side, then it will become plus. Okay, then it will become plus. Now see, n is here, for n which side is given? Minus. For n which side is given? See, I have explained you. If here it is minus, if we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become plus. N is here, minus. Suppose I want to transfer this n variable to the right hand side, then it will become plus. So 15 is equal to sign, give as it is down of is equal to sign. Now again I will write minus n here. No, why I will not write minus n here? Because I am going to transfer this n to the right hand side. So right hand side number first write as it is, 9 as it is. Okay, so n is here minus. If I will transfer to right hand side, then it will become plus n. Understood? See, here it is minus. If we will transfer to right hand side, then it will become plus. Okay, now I want to find the answer value of n. Okay, value of n. So what I need to do? I need to transfer 9 to the left hand side. Now 9 is here, plus. If the number is plus for right hand side, this is right hand side, this is left hand side. Everyone knows that. This is LHS and this is RHS. Left hand side, right hand side. Okay. So now 9 is here, plus for right hand side. If I will transfer to left hand side, then it will become minus. So 50, left hand side number. 9 is here, plus for right hand side. If I will transfer 9 to the left hand side, then it will become minus. So 15, left side number as it is, we have to write 9, will transfer to left hand side, then it will become minus. Okay, so is equal to, now 9 I transfer this side, again I have to write here. No, once we transfer the number, we do not have to write it again. Okay, so now which number will remain here? N will remain. 9 I have transferred to left hand side. Okay, now 15 minus 9, do the subtraction, what I will get? 6. So n value what I will get? 6. Therefore n is equal to 6. So the number is 6. So if the number less than 15 be subtracted from 15, the result is 9. So we have to find the n. So the number is 6. So solve question number 15. If the number I am thinking of be added to 25, the result is 48. Here variable is given. See the number. If the number I am thinking, which number I am thinking? You don't know. Okay, we don't know the number I am thinking. I also don't know which number I am thinking. So what I will consider of that letter be C. Okay. So let the number I am thinking B, which letter C we have to use? Okay, which number we have to use? C. Okay, let the number I am thinking be C. Okay, means C we have to consider. If the number I am thinking that number what I took? C. Okay. Of B added to 25. So this number B added to 25. B added means it is added to 25. So the result is 14. So now listen. See, let the number I am thinking be C means the number which I am thinking that what I consider C. Okay. So if the number I am thinking means that is C. Of B added, so C B added to 25, so C added to 25, so we add C into 25. Okay, we have to add C to 25. Okay, the result is 48. Result is 48. When I will add the number which is in mind, in that if I will add 25. If the number I am thinking of be added to 25. Okay. Be added to 25. Thinking number I added to 25. The result is 48. So is equal to 48. The result is 48. Result is 48. So is equal to 48. See, once again, see, we should know to form equation. Equation is correct, then we can solve the example. But if we will do the equation wrong, then our answer will come wrong. So take care while create the equation. Okay. If the number I am thinking, the number which I am thinking that I consider C here, given letter C. Okay. If the variable is not given, means the letter is not given. At that time, what we have to do? We have to take our own letter. At that time we have to take our own letter, but it is given here. So we have to take C. The number I am thinking be C means C number. Okay, that is C. Okay, I am thinking of B added to 25. So this number added to 25. So C here 25. So C we added to 25. The result is 48. When I will add in 25, what I will get answer? 48. The result is 48 means when I add my thinking with the number which I am thinking, if I will add in 25, I will get the result 48 means I will get the answer 48. So what is this number? We have to find the value of C. Okay, means what number is C that we have to find? Now you know the transposer rule. Okay, now C, we have to keep C here only. What we will do? We will transfer 25 to the right hand side. For 25 here there is no sign, means which sign? Plus sign. For 25 here there is no sign, means plus sign. If we will transfer 25 to the right hand side, then it will become minus 25. Okay, so now which number we are going to transfer? 25 we are going to transfer. So C will write as it is. Okay, so we will write C as it is. Again, I will write here 25? No, because 25 I am going right hand side number first write as it is. Okay, 48 I will write as it is. Now which number I am going to transfer? 25. 25 is here plus. See, before this number there is no sign, means plus sign. So if we will transfer 25 to the right hand side, then it will become minus 25. Okay. So now write, find the value of C. 48 minus 25. So 8 minus 5, 3, 4 minus 2, 2. So what is the value of C? C is equal to 23. So C is equal to 23. Means now we consider for which let the number, means if the number I am thinking. So which number I am thinking, that is 23, that I consider C. The number I am thinking B, C, means that I consider C. Okay, the number which I am thinking, that is C. And we got the value C, 23. So thinking number is 23. Understood? See, now we will solve question number 21. Okay, before that what it is written in? Question number 21 to 24, state in words the general rule obtained, means what rule obtained that we have to write in words. Okay, now question number 21, if A and B are odd numbers, what it is given? A and B are odd numbers. A is an even number, then A plus B is equal to N. See, A plus B is equal to N. It is given. And this general rule obtained that we have to write in the words. This rule it is given. This equation is given that we have to write in the words. Okay. Now, A and B are odd numbers. Now, what it is given? A and B are odd numbers. And what it is given? M is an even number. M is an even number. See, A and B odd numbers. What it is given? Odd numbers. Okay. And M is an even number. Even number. M is even number. So how we write this rule in words? Sum of two odd numbers is even number. See, till question number 20, what it was given? We have to create the equation. We have to form the equation. It was given in words. Till question number 20, it was given in words and we have to create the equation. Now here equation is given, means rule is given, and we have to write in the words. Okay, we have to write in the words. So now what it is given? A and B odd numbers and A is even number. So how we will write the same in the words? Sum of two odd numbers is an even number. Okay, sum of two odd numbers is an even number. See, this rule is there or not? Sum of two odd numbers, it is given here, A and B are two odd numbers. It is given in the question. Okay, A and B are two odd numbers and N is an even number. It is given in the question. So I have written down of A and B odd numbers and down of N even numbers. So what we can write in words? Sum of two odd numbers. Now no need to write A and B. Sum of, here two odd numbers are given. Sum of two odd numbers is an even number. See, let's see this is correct or not. Now take A. Odd numbers, what it is given? A and B are odd numbers. So take any two odd numbers. Now which are the odd numbers? Numbers ends with 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. Means at once plus if 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. These numbers are there. Then that numbers are odd numbers. Okay. So take any two odd numbers here. See here I will take 3 and another number 5. So sum of two odd numbers. Okay. 3 plus 5 and sum of two odd numbers. I got even number. 8 is an even number or not? Sum of two odd numbers is an even number. Got it? See, we can take any two odd numbers. You add it, you will get even number. So that only we have to write in words. Okay. So let's write in words. This is for your understanding I have shown. So write sum of two odd numbers. So write sum of two odd numbers is an even number. Okay. Sum of two odd numbers is an even number. Okay. Let's solve question number 22. X, Y are any numbers. Means X and Y, it is given these are any numbers. Okay. Then, Y plus X is equal to X plus Y. X and Y any number. Then, Y plus X is equal to X plus Y. So, let's take some values for X and Y to check this whether this is correct or wrong. Okay. So, for that what we do for X. X will take suppose 2 and Y will take suppose 3. Okay. X value is 2 and Y value will take 3. Okay. For understanding just I am showing you this. Okay. Now, Y value 3. Then put value of Y down of Y. How much it is? 3. Okay. Plus, what X we have considered? 2. Here I wrote 2. Okay. Now, X value 2 plus Y value, what it is given? Y value is 3. Okay. This is for understanding. I am showing you example. What it is given? X and Y are any numbers. Means these are any numbers. Then Y plus X is equal to X plus Y. Means we have to see whether Y plus X is equal to X plus Y. See, what I did? Y plus X. Now Y value 3, X value 2. So 3 plus 2, 5 we got. Let's check what it has done. These are the interchange numbers. See, here Y plus X and here X plus Y. Even though we are getting same answer or not, that we have to see. Okay. So 2 plus 3, 5. So both are equal or not? Even we change the order, we get the same answer or not. See, what is here? Y plus X. Y plus X. And here X plus Y. So even we change the order, we get the answer same. Even we change the order, we got the answer same. Yes or no? So from this, what we understand from this, the sum of two numbers, the sum of two numbers remains same. What we got? Sum of two numbers remains same. Remains the same. Even if their order is changed. Okay, the sum of two numbers, we have to write in words. This is the given rule. What rule is given in the question? Y plus X is equal to X plus Y. Okay, what it is given? X and Y are any numbers. These are any numbers it is given. It is not given. It is even number or odd number. Any numbers. Then Y plus X is equal to X plus Y. So we check if these are any numbers. So what I took? X is equal to 2 I took and Y is equal to 3. What it is done in this? It has changed the order. See here y plus x and here x plus y. Even we get that number value in the equation. Okay, y 3 and x is 2. So 3 plus 2, 5. Here it is order change. Here y plus x, here x plus y. So x value I have written here 2 plus y value 3. So 2 plus 3, 5. Even we change the order, the answer we got same. So the sum of two numbers remains the same even if their order is changed. The sum of two numbers, these are the two numbers. The sum of two numbers remains the same even if their order is changed. These are the two numbers, y plus x. Okay. And here what it has done? Here only change the order of that number. Here y plus x and here x plus y. Only just here change the order. Even the answer we got same. Okay, so the sum of two numbers remains the same even if their order is changed. See, here I have taken my own example. See, here I took my own example. Okay, you can write your own numbers and you can check and you can write this sentence. Okay, this is for your understanding. I have written. Okay, you can write in the place of this any numbers. You can check and you can write this sentence. The sum of two numbers remains the same even if their order is changed. Okay, this is the answer. This sentence we want. Before that, whatever I have shown, that is just for your understanding. I have written that it may change as per your members. You may take another numbers and you can check and you can write them. Okay, so this is important. This you have to write in sentence. It is given in the question. You have to write the sentence, you have to write in the words.